what we are doing, we are rescuing the children off the streets and also especially from the brothel homes, and rescuing them and bringing them into our children's home and taking care of them.
When you give, you help children and young people experience love and family for the first time. You help about 300 people learn about God each week in their communities where they live and grow. And you change lives, you change communities, you change children's lives by sending them to school and helping them break the cycle of poverty that their families are in. When you give love and you give hope and you give an opportunity for a different tomorrow.
So in the 11 years that we've been in New Zealand, we have been able to start three not-for-profits that are actually government participated and partially funded. We've been able to plant a church now that we have around 55 members of that church. And the thing that we're really, proud might not be the right word, but something that we are excited about is out of those people who come, only 4 people had ever stepped foot in a church or had any kind of connection with Christianity before that. We are getting to tell people about the gospel, about Jesus, and we're running to people in a westernized society who have never heard the name of Jesus, had never heard the story of Jesus. And as an Oklahoma boy, that was just unheard of.
And I think what is exciting is to see that there are so many people who are willing or who have the hunger to listen to the word of God, and not only the hunger to listen to, but they also want to submit under this kingship or the lordship of Jesus Christ.
We appreciate the prayers that you all have prayed for us, and we pray for you guys as well. We've been blessed to have this building that we just are so thankful for, the space that it creates, that it created. We're really thankful for that. We pray for it, and God bless us with it.
When we went back to Panama in 1999, we went with 3 specific goals. One, to establish a mature congregation in Panama City. When we say mature, we're talking about a growing church with elders and deacons, an organized church that is growing in love, in sanctity, in sharing the gospel, having a strong leadership. Second, we went with the purpose of establishing churches in the main cities of Panama, and we're working on that right now. And thirdly, to establish a Christian school. And we began an elementary school in Panama City. So now we want to have a junior high and a high school in the center of the metropolitan city.
The biggest part of Creation for Christ ministry is TV ministry. We are producing and broadcasting Christian messages on local TV stations all across Croatia. Just from the last week, we became nationwide TV ministry. In the last 3 years, Croatia for Christ became a partner with Eastern European Mission, distributing children's Bibles across Croatia and Bosnia and Herzegovina, our neighboring country. So far, we put 226,000 children's Bibles into public schools in Croatia and Bosnia and Herzegovina. Right now, we have a request for additional 400,000 children's Bibles that we are planning to put into public schools in the next 2 or 3 years.
In 2019, we built the largest children's home school building in India. And not only we bringing children off the roads and brothel homes, then we are providing a very good Christian solid education for them. I just want to say thank you for the wonderful people at Park Church of Christ. We need your prayers for our safety. When we are doing this, we have a lot of opposition from other people. So we need your lot of prayers for these children, for rescuing them.
There's a lot of abuse and domestic violence. Addiction is high, especially in West Auckland, which is where we minister and live. So we saw a lot of this need and realized that what was going on was a need for people to come in and help transform community to be a healthier place and a safe place for everybody. And we believed that Jesus teaches the best way to do that. And so we knew that when we came in, we had an automatic ministry that could show the love of Jesus in the community by helping make those places better and healthier.
We could just see God's footstep moving in Holly Grove. And although, you know, there are some dry spells, but there are also some fruitfulness that comes along with those dry spells. And we're just really thankful for those prayers.
Everything that we're doing would not be possible without you, without your faithful support, without the Park Plaza Church. And I would like to thank you for the faithful financial support that you are providing in this crazy year of coronavirus.
I am really grateful for the mission teams that come and the groups that come to Panama, because they encourage the members that are there with their maturity in the Word and sharing their faith. They can see that this is something that they can accomplish in the future. They can reach out to people within Panama and take the gospel just as these small groups do. And it's been an encouragement to us to see that they're involved with the work we're doing, not only by praying from afar, but also by coming and experiencing what we do on a daily basis.
Personally, what I would like your prayers for is just for God to keep on giving me the strength. If you can pray for us, for God to give us courage, because there are some areas where you go into, you don't know if you'll come back. But if He can give us that courage to not let anything stop us, but make sure that wherever there are people, we will go.